What's up, everybody? Deacon Jay here, and it is a beautiful day in Northern California. I am up here at Knights Ferry, taking in the views. So it's been kind of a rough week, let's just say. So I had to get out here and get into nature and kind of just walk around a bit. I don't know if you can hear that, but there's definitely some chicks up there. Some sort of baby birds. And I know I filmed all this stuff before, but you know what? It's my vlog. It's been my lousy 2 weeks. I'm allowed to film what I want. Yeah, these boards are feeling kind of rotten. And loose. Here's a better shot of the mill. So yeah, it's been a stressful kind of couple weeks. Is just, you know what, give me 1 second, I want to leave this on while I do this, because it always looks slightly slanted in the viewfinder, so, I better, a little bit I guess, well, maybe not. Hopefully I'm not filming this at an angle, but, yeah, after the hit and run and coming to the knowledge that there's no way the cops were going to catch those guys, and then that GMC on Tuesday almost hit me, that just really kind of didn't do much for my confidence. Just kind of felt like, oh crap, one thing. Thank you. Yeah, I know I'm not doing a whole lot of talking, but honestly, I don't have much to say at the moment. There's some things I'm going to talk about in this vlog, but at the moment, I just want to take in the sights and the peacefulness of it. Uh-oh, there's a predator here. So it has been a rough week, a couple weeks really, involved in a hit and run. Well, I shouldn't say involved. I was a victim of a hit and run. And then the following day, I almost got rear-ended again by another guy in a GMC truck. So, yeah, I've been kind of having a skittish few days. I don't really want to talk about it anymore. The police will never catch them, unfortunately. And it's just unfortunately the reality of it, but you know what, so be it. I have camping trips coming up. I have History's Mysteries coming up at Columbia, so I got a lot of positive stuff to look forward to. So another thing I should mention is I am trying out a new tripod to use as both a tripod and a hand grip for my camera. And so far, it seems to be a little bit more steady. I don't know. One of the weird things about this camera, and I apologize if it does it, but when I'm recording, a lot of times what is in the viewfinder, is that what you call a little LED screen now, still? A lot of times it'll be at an angle, and I'm looking at the camera, and the camera's not at an angle, so I don't know if I'm shooting at an angle or... So, if it is at any sort of an angle, I apologize. Doesn't look like the camera is, so... So I have to admit, I'm a little apprehensive, is that the term? Because there actually was a machete attack up here. It happened like a week before the one on the AT happened. The one that happened on the AT ended up being fatal. I think it was a machete attack, at least a knife attack. Whereas I think the guy that did it here just got arrested, and then I think somebody died in a boating thing here recently too, so. All very unfortunate events. And, sad thing to happen somewhere so absolutely peaceful. Another reason I decided to come out here today is I really need to get some miles under my feet. I have a couple trips coming up, and they involve hiking. I'm going up to Seattle, and gonna hang out there for one day, and then after that, my friend Adam and I, are heading over to the Olympic National Park. And doing a 3-day, 2-night backpacking trip. It's gonna be a blast. I'm looking forward to it because I have not been properly camped out in a while. I've done parking camp a lot, but I'm now at the point where I really just don't want to do parking camp anymore. Which is funny because I have friends who are now just absolute avid RVers. And, you know, it just means at some point I'll have to dive into all of that. But for now, I want to go hammock camp and put as many miles under my feet as I can. And yeah. So over the last couple months, a lot of things have been going on that have really prevented me from doing too much of anything that I've wanted to really do. Where do I want to go? Yeah, let's go this way. And then up. For one, I had some electrical issues in my kitchen, followed by some plumbing issues in my kitchen. And, you know, that took a while to sort out. And then, because of all the storms, my fence started coming down, so instead of going anywhere, I was putting all my money aside for a new fence, basically. So, and then the accident happened, so that money that was put aside for the fence had to go towards my deductible and all that. So I'm not gonna lie. The uphill that I'm doing, because I've been up and down this a couple times now, is now officially whooping my butt a little bit. Now that there's a breeze, but it is already warm out here, so hopefully during the trip up in Washington, it will be cooler days. Not rain, just cooler, I hope. So, the other reason I'm going this way instead of further up the hill and to the other sweet spot that I like to go to, a large crowd of people just went that way, so people go one way, I go the other, so. Anyway, for the Washington and Point Reyes trips, more for the Washington trip, I'll be tent camping at Point Reyes. I did pick up a war bonnet, Blackbird XLC, double layer, which is a nice hammock. I also basically got their pod system, the winter top and quilt protector. But if you zip them together, they're a pod system. So, got a new underground quilt, top quilt, rated at 30 degrees. Got an underquilt from Hammock Gear, premium incubator, also 30 degrees. So, yeah. Already had the winter tarp, which I might end up regretting because it is over a pound, and without my bear canister, I'm at 13 pounds. It's also without my med kit and a few other things. Throw my bear canister in there. I'm hitting 22. So, I had a little bit of a fit yesterday because I weighed my pack with everything. And it was at 23 pounds. I'm like, damn it. So, there's probably going to be a few things that I'm going to leave behind that I wouldn't have necessarily before. Sorry. Hopefully I'm not getting weird angles with this camera. So, in case you couldn't tell, yeah, I am sweating. It's hot out. Coffee hasn't quite kicked in yet, so, you know, as soon as that happens, I'll be a little more energetic, so, crap. I'm not looking at the camera, so I don't notice that I'm like, oh, I'm down here. It's also why I don't really do the selfie stuff too much. Whoever threw that bottle up there, you're a dick. So I don't know if you can hear that in the background. That is boats being inflated. A bunch of rafts. Pretty cool. Might actually come up here one day and see about doing that. You know, get the information on it. See how many people it requires, if you can group up with other people. And all that. So, I've never walked this path before. It's kind of interesting. I kind of prefer the one with all the rocks and the dirt and all of that, but oh, here we go. Here's some water. Excuse me. Uncharted territory. So yeah, I got the top quilt, underquilt, new tarp, new hammock. The weight's a little bit ridiculous, but you know, it's lighter than it would have been. Stove-wise, I'm taking the BSRs. I'm taking two of them because I tend to lose them. They weigh nothing, so not a big deal. It's a little over 6 miles from the trailhead to the campsite, so day one will be just getting up to there, setting up, just enjoying it. Leisurely trip up there. We should be able to do that in a couple hours, you know, 3 hours. There's gonna be a lot of breaks, a lot of things we're going to be filming while up there. So he's a photographer. I'm going to be doing vlogs and photography, so we're also planning on doing some skits, making fun of some backpacking tropes and YouTube tropes in general, so. Things like this, or the walking past the camera thing. So, Point Reyes will be a overnight trip. Nothing terribly exciting. Just a short walk in. I'm going to be taking my Cloudburst 3, and by then I might have bought a new sleep pad, but I'm going to just take the two that I have and band them together. So. That'll be a fun little trip. I'll probably just get away with my little 45 liter bag on that one, maybe. We'll see. Oh. So starting soon, I will be performing up at Columbia State Historic Park as part of History's Mysteries, so I am absolutely looking forward to that. I am getting a couple shots of the bridge that I have never gotten before. I've never actually been over here, so. Which is kind of sad because I have been up to Knights Ferry about 100 times. So. That's interesting. A giant rock cross. Huh. Interesting. Weird. So, yeah. I don't know if I can get a different snapshot of this, but I'm gonna go over here and check it out. I guess this is, I've never seen water over here, so I always wonder. Now I know that there used to be a lot more water flowing through these areas because where I live there's a road called something ferry, I can't think of it offhand, and there's River Road and all of that, and according to one of the books that I've gotten on the town I live in, they used to actually have ferries, so, huh. Oh geez, that just scared the hell out of me. I know that they can't sting, or they don't sting, but it's still a big flying bug. They're the puppers of the bee world. Can you imagine doing 10 miles just on this? Yeesh. With the exception of the heavy machinery beeping as it backs up and the sound of the pump, air compressor pumping up those rafts, it's fairly peaceful up here. Trash can. So yeah, it's pretty peaceful up here. Pays to come up here early. So as I was mentioning before getting distracted over there, I'm going to be performing as part of History's Mysteries up at Columbia State Historic Park starting next weekend. So that's another reason why I really needed to get out here and film something, because for those weeks I will probably not be able to record anything. Maybe some car vlogs, but other than that, I really don't know. And then some other things are happening after, right after that. And then a little while after that, there's the Washington trip and the trip to Point Reyes. So, yeah, a lot of things going on. A lot of positive things going on, which is a good thing. But, yeah. Sorry, I am beat. This last 2 weeks have really drained me. Kind of emotionally. Just the havoc that the hit and run caused. And, you know, the realization that, you know, those guys will never be caught. Being without my car for a few days, you know, 10 days, and so I'm just going to sit here and stare at the water for a while. I don't want the trash can in the shot. Is it still in there? Yep. Yeah, that's good. I'm not going to cut any of that out, but from here. So I don't know if I'm sold on this tripod. It's one of the ones with all the joints in the legs that you can position in weird positions and wrap it around poles and things. Seems to work, but the, I don't know. We'll see. I mean, it's pretty good grip. So I'll have to wait and see how steady it actually looks when I get home. keep having to do that where I'm choking up on it a bit, so. We'll see. All right, on to the next.